it's been overwhelming. It's a lot. But I mean, you just got to keep pushing and get through it. I mean, I'm taking it as a great opportunity because a lot of people don't get this chance to do this. So, I mean, I'm just doing the best I can and just trying to show teams what I got.
There's a lot of great bigs in the league who do multiple things, and you know, one may not be able to do that, but they can do that. And you know, just being able to step on the court and, you know, get a chance to showcase my skill set and, you know, showcase that I'm coachable and things like that, you know, just it's really big.
You know, what stood out to me in the meetings and the interviews was just like, you know, how versatile I am at 6'9", I can shoot the ball and dribble. And, you know, that's what the NBA is, you know, developing players now.
I think playing in the best conference in the country against the best players in the country and showing that I can hold my own and do more than expected is something that's going to help me in my life and my future, even if it's not at the NBA level or somewhere else. I think just the ability to play the game I love is just what I want to do no matter where it's at.
I think I've done a great job this year, you know, this being my first year at Michigan, to show many different aspects of my game. And I think it's just, you know, me being mentally ready. I think I'm mature enough, and I think I have the mentality to succeed at the next level.
I think the biggest thing is my defense coming in as a second guard and being able to conduct the team as a second string guard and also be able to make the ball screen reads. I think that's the biggest thing with me is being able to show teams that I'm able to make the right reads with the ball, whether it's from the pick and roll to the seeing the play that's on the backside.
Yes, coming through the working process that I've been doing, you know, I've taken a real big toll on being able to contain people off of ball screens, contain people on the post, you know, trying to play physical with everybody on the court, not being the weakest man out there. You know, I take it real big on being able to move my feet when it comes to, you know, guarding guards, when it comes off the screen, being able to contain guards so, you know, our guard can get back, or if we have to switch, being able to contain them to keep them from scoring. So I take a real big, you know, toll on that. It's like a real big mindset for me. I try to base defense, you know, as the main point of my game.
I think one is my ability to make free throws. I think that really gonna keep me on the court, you know, especially that crucial time of the game where, you know, it comes down to fouling free throws. You know, I think my ability to really step to the line and knock down free throws is one thing. And my ability to space the floor, you know, just my ability to space the floor. And, you know, being able to impact the game in so many ways, I think I'm able to do that, you know, just on offensive end. You know, at the end of the day, big guys are still needed to block shots. Big guys are still needed to rebound. Big guys are still needed to set a screen. So, you know, just for me to be able to do all these little things really, you know, set me apart.
Just keeping that underdog mentality, you know, kind of the edge that Michigan State, you know, you kind of play with when you learn, when you go there. And just being tough and just, you know, doing the little things and just paying attention to detail and, you know, just trying to do all those things to help you stand out as best as you can. I'm a competitor, you know, I shoot the three. You know, I'm more than just a shooter. I can put it on the floor and make passes and make plays for my teammates. You know, ever since I was a little kid, it's always been my dream to play in the NBA. And that's why I went to Michigan State, because I thought it was the best opportunity to put me in that position. I mean, I just felt like through my years at Michigan State, you know, just getting better every year, you know, just seemed like I could do it, and just believing in myself and my teammates at Michigan State believing in me, you know, it helps a lot. Just take it day by day, you know. You're not gonna, you know, get drafted or picked up like that. You know, it takes time. It's a process. It's a long process. You just got to put in the work and trust yourself.
It's great, you know. I've never really been out this way too many times, except for to come to a couple Pistons games. But just to be able to get back to my hometown and be able to work off with a pro team is pretty good.
I sort of made myself a defensive player because I knew that's something that keep me on the floor as well. So just be able to get stops, I can knock down shots as well. So that's one of the major things in this league, is be able to get stops, knock down shots.
I feel like my game is more towards natural NBA right now. With my ability and size and things I can do, I feel like it's a need in the NBA. And I feel like it was time for me to make the jump and leave college. You're playing with the best, training with the best, being coached by the best, and I want to be one of the best. So that's where everyone wants to be. That's where everyone's childhood dream is, to be in the NBA. And just the development they have, all the different options they have, leagues they have, is just good for young guys, and even guys that are still established in the league. Just keep getting better, because the training you have in the NBA is just bar none. So draft day is really close, and you just said, just take every workout one by one and just show what you can do, and don't try and play out of your character.